today we are going to talk about the AGV AX9, the adventure helmet from AGV. So first of all, let me tell you why I got the AGV AX9. So I'll take you through the journey, how I decided to buy a helmet. I've been staying in Dubai for the last 9 years, and I've always wanted to get a bike since I moved here. But the first thing that I did was get my driver's license for a car, got a car, and then I was pretty much comfortable with the car, and I've been driving my car for the last 6 years now. And but recently, like last year, 2020, me and a couple of my friends, we decided that, you know, we should get a bike and we should start riding. So that idea popped in, and then it's been there since last year, but we haven't done anything on it. But recently, I was just suddenly motivated to get a bike. So first thing I had to do was get a license before I get a bike. To get a license, I needed a helmet, in order to do my classes and practice on the bike. So I thought that, you know, instead of buying a temporary helmet for the classes, I would just get a permanent helmet, a good helmet. I would invest in a good helmet so I can use it on my bike as well. That's why I got the AGV AX9. So different types of helmets are available in the market. One is the basic one is open face helmet, where you just have an open face, sometimes a visor on top of it to protect against the wind. That's it. There's a modular helmet or a flip type helmet where the chin guard comes up, which is used mostly for touring by tourers, so that, you know, you have the ease of taking the flip up and then sipping on water maybe or something. And then the third type, or I feel the best type, is the full face helmet, which is the safest because it's got a full face, the structure is intact. The only disadvantage I would say of a full face helmet would be getting the air in or the ventilation, because it's a closed type helmet. So you need to think about the ventilation or whatever is comfortable for you. But the remaining two helmets have pretty good ventilation, obviously. I bought an AGV AX9 because I'm planning to buy an adventure bike. So yes, I got a full face helmet and an AGV AX9. It was pretty expensive. It costed me around 2000 dirhams. If you buy it from the US or somewhere else, it would be definitely cheaper. Here it's expensive. I couldn't negotiate. I just got like a 10% discount, which was very minimal. But yeah, I just wanted to have that helmet from AGV. I like the brand. I've been a fan of that brand since a long time. And I really like the helmet and the colors. So let me show you what I've got here. So that's the box. Comes in black color with AGV branding all around. There's a hologram here, and then there's a QR code which you can scan on your phone. So once you do that, it'll take you to the AGV website, where you can actually see the product that's packed inside. It will say you have purchased the original AGV helmet, and it's not a black market or a copy. So you can see all the details of your helmet that you have purchased. It's AX9 Siberia matte black yellow flow. So that's the color scheme of the helmet. So you get all the details online, you get your warranty details and stuff. You have the technical information of your helmet all online just by scanning that QR code. It'll take you to the AGV website. Pretty helpful. So let's just open this helmet. Okay, so comes in a black cover as well. You can see the beak right away, which tells you it's an adventure helmet. Let me just open up the cover. I've opened it previously, but I just packed and kept it until I start my classes. I haven't started my motorbiking classes yet, which I will be doing by next week. And I will also be posting a video about how to get your motorcycle license in UAE. So that's the black cover. Let's keep it aside. The plastic cover again. So that's the helmet. You can see I really like the color gray and the graphics that they have done on it. I think there are a couple of options more available, but this was my favorite one. The bright lines, the yellow bright lines, fluorescent lines look really nice and pretty visible. If you are riding in the dark, it would be really helpful. So as you can see, it's got a front bend at the chin, as all the full face helmets have, and it is operable with a button. You can just open and close it as per the ventilation you want. This part can also be removed, the mesh in front, and you can get a continuous airflow and more airflow into your helmet if it's a really hot day, or if you're riding off-road, because the wind would be less. So yeah, you can just increase the airflow in there. Then it comes with these two tabs to pull the helmet up, so you'll have to use both the tabs to effectively open the visor. It doesn't come with a locking system for the visor itself. It's a clip-in type system, but works pretty smoothly. AGV advises to have the beak right up. The beak is adjustable, by the way, but they advise to keep the beak right in the top position so the visor can go up freely. And yeah, you've got these settings. Then you have on the inside, there is a flip switch which will direct the air. If you keep it down, the air would go straight through on your face. If you flip it up, it will divert the air right on top of your head, and it would go out of these permanently open vents. Then there are vents here as well on top of your helmet, which can be closed and opened. Of course, in Dubai, I feel that these would be open all the time. I would be riding with open vents all the time, and this one as well. Then inside, you can see it's pretty plush finishes. Very comfortable, very soft, the finishes. It's got a chin protection as well, or a chin cushioning, you can say. So this here is a really soft material, which is mostly going to touch against your face. Even on the inside, it's a really soft material. When this helmet fits on your head, it will form like a seal around your head, and it will protect you from all the wind going through or anything going through. It will just form like a complete seal around your head. It will give you a nice tight fit, snug fit. But all these components are removable, so the chin part can be just pulled out from here, so as in to let more air in into your helmet. These parts can be removed for washing later. This is a medium large size, and it says 58 to 59. And the way you measure your head size or helmet size is, you just take a soft measuring tape and you put it around your head at this part, and you measure your size of the head. Mine came out to be 59 centimeters, so that's why I've got the medium large, 58-59 size. Yeah, it fits pretty comfortable to me. I will just try it on later. What else? So the beak, I haven't tried the helmet on the bike itself, because I haven't started my classes yet, which I would be doing from the next week. and then I would get my bike, and then I would maybe do a full review, or let's see. Yeah, but I've heard good reviews of this helmet. The noise is not much, and they say it's a 70-30 helmet. That means, you know, 70% of the helmet is designed to be ridden on roads, fast speeds, and 30 you can say to be ridden on off roads. Yeah. And yeah, you can see that it's got the buckle type fit around the chin to strap the helmet on, which is a very traditional fit that they say, and it's one of the safest fits ever made. Let's see what else is in the box now. So there's pin lock, visor cover. So what pin lock does is, pin lock is a fog resistant film, you can say, which you install inside your visor. And I haven't installed mine yet. I would do on foggy days, or if it starts getting too much foggy inside the helmet. I don't want to use it immediately. I would like to just try the helmet on without the pin lock film, and then see later. And it's pretty easy to install. You can check out the videos, instruction videos, on the pin lock website itself. Then we have this, which contains the AGV AX9 product manual. You can get all the information regarding the AGV AX9 helmet. And then there's a safety booklet, providing you all the safety information on the AGV helmet. There are a couple of stickers inside here if you want to put them on your bike or somewhere. Then once this beak comes off, you will see the screw holes. So they have given some rubber bushings to cover those screw holes. I'm not sure if I'm going to remove the beak, but only once I ride, I would see what I'm going to do. And the visor itself, so one good advantage of the adventure helmets is it will give you a huge field of vision where the other helmets fail to do that. I mean, the full face helmets, say I've tried the AGV K6, which was one of my favorite helmets while I was looking for helmets. But K6 is mostly designed for like sports bikes, super bikes, and has lesser field of vision. It's lighter than this. I think it's a 1200 gram helmet. This one is a 1600 gram helmet. And both are carbon armored shell, which is pretty light and very durable as helmet shells. So the field of vision, what AGV say, is it's 190 degrees horizontally and 110 degrees vertically, which is pretty good. I mean, once you wear it, you will you can see pretty much clearly around you while you're riding. You can do your head checks very safely. That's why this helmet is much recommended for adventure tourers or adventure bikes, where you need to have the maneuverability, the visibility around, because you are constantly moving or doing your maneuvers. Let's go ahead and try this helmet on and let's see how it fits. As you can see, it's a very snug fit. You might see my cheeks getting pressed here, or but this is not at all uncomfortable. At least, I mean, when you're buying a helmet, you definitely need to check how it fits around your head first. This is the secondary part, and this also might get loose, like by 5 mm or so. When you're using it, it'll definitely get loose. But yeah, around the head, it's pretty much comfortable, because that's what matters while you're riding. You need to like wear the helmet and see before if there are any pressure points created. Another thing you can check while buying a helmet other than the sizes, you can just insert your finger from this part and see how easily it fits through. If it's slightly tight to fit through, that means this is a good size of helmet. If it's easily going through, that means the helmet is loose and you shouldn't buy it. That's just a check you can perform while buying a helmet. But all in all, you go for the comfort around your head and don't just base your decision on the cheeks. I mean, my cheeks, you can see they are pretty pressed right now, but yeah, I mean, it'll work around and it'll get loose as I keep using the helmet. Yes. So yeah, that's my AGV AX9, and yeah, I really like the helmet a lot, and I'm hoping to wear it on the bike and ride. Maybe I'll do another review, or you know, like an update on how the helmet performs or how it feels later once I start riding. Yeah, so see you guys soon.